back again, the infamous Norma Jean.
Love it to me.
albums, if you could pick one song in general, which one would it be that you would rewrite? Yeah, that's kind of a hard one, huh?
The thing is, though, like,
if there was even like a chunk of a song, you know? I know, but say in like the final edit of a record that comes out.
We change almost every song. Like, I think it's cool when a song is different live than it is on the album. I know a lot of bands really try like to shoot for like perfection, and that's cool. We know we're not gonna achieve that. So we just kind of embrace like messing it up and going with it, you know? Like,
there you go.
So I don't know if there's anything, if I was gonna rewrite something.
Let's just say offer like poor similar in general. It's a hard one.
I don't think I would. I think I would go back further.
Even further?
Oh God, the Aftermath, Times.
Okay.
I think it's not necessarily like rewriting the song, but it's more like the production value of it.
Regrouping of like, how the song is.
Letting it be a lot messier. More so like how Redeemer was made. It's very stringy and
awesome album.
And wild. And but I at the same time too, if we didn't do Oh God the Aftermath the way we did, we would have still been bad at guitar.
Yeah, there we go.
We have Matt Bayless who was, you know, play better and it caused us to pay attention to our instruments better. And I think that so helpful to our songwriting in the future.
There you go.
And then you find
for the anti-mother crew out there.
Thin walls, room 212. Oh my. That shower is bigger than ours. What? Ah, I'm fat. How'd it feel to stay in the Pearl District for another night?
I don't think this is the Pearl District.
It's just it is the Pearl District.
No, it's dirty.
It's very dirty? Well, that's a given when you stay in Portland. Portland in general. Now let's go get some breakfast at Whole Foods. Good old Cute Street.